Chapter 3 discusses, among other things, variables and arithmetic operators. Now, the project that I'm going to demonstrate takes three integer inputs and multiplies them to create a volume. So we're going to accept the length, width, and height values input by the user. We'll click the calculate button. It will calculate the volume and display the volume in the label down here. We're going to create a new Windows project, and remember that when you create your new project, make sure it's a Windows Forms application. Change the name of your project. You could call this one Willow Pools or Chapter 2 Project A. Again, I'm going to recommend you don't put any spaces in your file names. When our project is created, as always, we start with a blank form. I'm going to open up my toolbox, and I kept the sample project running so we could look at it occasionally. Let me remind you that you're going to have 1, 2, 3, 4 prompt labels and one active display label. Remember, I refer to these prompt labels as prompts or static labels, one active display label. We have 3 text boxes and 2 command buttons. There's our 2 buttons, 3 text boxes, 4 prompt labels, and don't forget one more label that's going to be our display label. Now, in this video demonstration, for the sake of time, I'm not going to spend a lot of time organizing things to make them look nice and neat, but I want to make sure that you do that. Now, first things first, let's set the text property on our form. The next thing we want to do is configure the properties on our buttons. Remember, we do want to change the button name property. We're going to have a calc button and an exit button. I also want to change the text property on both. Now, remember that we're going to have keyboard access keys for every object that the user interacts with. And we set the keyboard access keys in the text property. This is the exit button. I want the X as the keyboard access key, so I'm going to precede the letter X with the ampersand. For the calc button, I want the C to be the keyboard access key, so I'm going to precede the C, the first C, with the ampersand. Now that we have our two buttons named, I want to go back to the form. So select the form, go to the form property, and let's set our accept button to our calc button, our accept button property of the form to the calc button. Remember, the accept button is associated with the enter key on the keyboard. The user hits the enter key, it gives the same effect as clicking the calculate button. We also want to set the cancel button property of the form, and we're going to set that one to the exit button. The calc button property of the form is associated with the escape key on the keyboard. The user hits the escape key, then the exit button is clicked, or it simulates clicking the exit. Okay, let's set our prompt labels. Our prompt labels are going to be length, height, width, or length, width, height. It doesn't really matter what order you put them in. Just know that whatever this prompt is associated with the text box that's going to accept the data for that particular factor. Remember, the prompt labels are never going to be referenced in the code, so we don't have to change the name property. We simply want to change the text properties. Also, we do want to use a keyboard access key for the text box, but since the text box is not going to have any text, we're going to assign the keyboard access key to the label, and then the label will be used to hold the access key so that the text box can get the focus. So for the length text box, I'm going to use the L as the keyboard access key. The W for the width, I'm going to use height, and the H is my keyboard access key. The last prompt label is for the volume. Now, since this is a prompt label that is prompting another label, the display label, since the display label can't have the focus, we don't need a keyboard access key here. So it's simply going to be volume in our text property for this label. Right, our display label. We want to treat this a little bit differently than our prompt labels. First of all, we want to set the name property because it will be referenced in our code. And it's going to be the volume label. But we also want to set the auto size property to false. When the auto size property is set to true, the size of the label is automatically adjusted to the text property. Since our text property is going to be empty initially with this label, we want to turn the auto size property to false. I also want to set the border style property to fixed single. Gives it that little black border line. But I also want to set the text align property. I want to set the text align property so that the volume is displayed nice and neatly in the center of the label. And finally, we're going to remove the text from the text property so that the label is blank, but we can see that rectangular border of the label. Okay, next, let's go to our text boxes. We're going to reset the names of our text boxes. We're going to set them to length text box. I'm going to set the text align property for this box as well to be centered. And I'm going to do the same thing for the other two. Remember that you can set some properties to multiple objects. So I've selected the other two text boxes and I'm setting the text align property to center. Now all I have to do is go and change the name properties for both of these text boxes. The width text box and the height text box. Before we get into code, there's one more thing I'd like to do that's very important. And again, some of these features that I'm showing you now, keyboard access keys, accept and cancel button properties on the form, and the tab index order, I want to see these features on every project from Chapter 2 and beyond. To set our tab index order, make sure you select the form, pull down the View menu, turn on the Tab Order view, click on each object in the logical sequential order that you think the user would use these objects. Be careful not to click that right away, but first of all, I want the user to start with the focus in the first text box, then go to the second text box and the third text box. However, that's not the tab index order I want. I want the tab index order to start with the length prompt so that the length prompt will get the focus first, but it can't have the focus because it's a label, so the focus then goes to the next object in the tab index order, the next object that can receive the focus. So again, using that same logic, since I want them to go to the second text box and then to the third text box, I'm clicking in the logical sequential order that the user would visit or interact with the objects. Once I've clicked on all the objects, I'm going to turn off tab order view. All right, before we write our code, let's save our project. I'm going to click on the Save All button, the project name. Make sure you browse and find the location of the project, the location where you want to store your project. You're probably going to use your USB drive. Make sure you find that location. I'm choosing the CST171 folder in the My Dropbox folder on my computer. Make sure the Create Directory for Solution is selected. And remember that you can have a solution name different than the project name. Once you have those four things set, click the Save button. Now let's get into our code.